I'm Claudia Flisi of the U.S. Italy Forum, and I'm here, it's my honor to be here, with General Kenneth McKenzie, Jr., former commander of the U.S. Central Command, and currently executive director in the University of Southern California's Global and National Security Institute. The general is a former veteran of practically everywhere in the Middle East, and he's just written a book called The Melting Point, High Command and War in the 21st Century, where he talks about some of the things he's seen and observed over more than 20 years working in the Middle East. So just a couple of quick questions. Of the title of the book, The Melting Point, you've already talked about this before. Where does it come from?
So, Claudia, it comes from Barbara Tuchman's great book on the beginning of World War I, The Guns of August. And in the book, she has a phrase, that melting point of warfare, the temperament of the individual commander. So I was a commander at when many significant events occurred, and it was a natural fit to lift the title from that.
Right. And you also talk in your book about three things that are important in terms of themes you've developed throughout the book, and one of them is the importance of leadership. So that ties in with leadership. What have you observed about leadership going through a whole series of U.S. presidents, what kind of leadership is best and most effective in the Middle East?
So I think the thing that's most important is whoever the president is, that president needs to get the complete apolitical support of the U.S. military, whether he's Republican, Democrat, does not matter to us. We need to have the same flat, if you will, approach when we give advice, and when orders are given, we need to follow those orders, regardless of the party affiliation of the president.
Now, does that matter if the president is a veteran or not, in terms of garnering respect?
You know, I don't think it does. I think the office carries an enormous amount of respect with it. And actually, as you know, we are loyal to the Constitution, not to any person. That's the oath we take.
That is true. General Smiley Miley pointed out. You talked about the fact that the main danger in the Middle East is Iran. Can you expand a little bit about this, given the recent contretemps between Israel and Iran?
So Iran threatens their neighbors. They've threatened them for many years. The degree of that threat has grown more direct in recent years, as Iran has expanded their ballistic missiles, their drones, and their land attack cruise missile fleet. They had an opportunity to test it, if you will,
in April.
The test failed. The Israelis, with the help of their neighbors and us, were able to defeat that attack. And the Israeli response was moderate and reasonable. So I think today Iran is weaker as a result of that attack. Israel is stronger.
One last question. You've been responsible for helping integrate Israel into defense in the Middle East, and that's sort of point of pride, not only for you, but for others who are observers of the Middle East. What happens when Netanyahu disappears?
So, political question, not a military question.
True,
and
an influence.
And I focus on the military component of it. But look, Israel is a democracy, and they will eventually produce a prime minister at some point, and then we'll deal with that personality, whoever it is. Just as in the United States, I try to stay out of the political track when it comes to talking about nations' leaders.
Right, but there's a problem in terms of Gaza right now that is a political problem that also becomes a military problem. Actually,
sure.
It is a military problem,
sure,
in the Middle East, but it's becoming a military problem outside of the Middle East as well. So what role can the military play in terms of the politics without getting involved in politics?
We give good advice. You know, we give good advice to our Israeli friends. They give us advice on things as well. So we talk about the best tactics, techniques, and procedures to use when you're fighting in Gaza that minimize damage to the civilian population and allow you to carry out your military objectives.
And you said that in Iran in April, Israel was judicious and restrained in its retaliation, and that was to be commended. Why haven't they learned that lesson in terms of Gaza?
Well, I'm not sure that the situations are comparable. Gaza's a tough position to fight. Hamas has chosen to embed within the population, which places Israeli commanders on a constant series of dilemmas as they go after targets. It's a very difficult situation. I wouldn't want to minimize that.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
Anyway, thank you. Appreciate
it. Thank you. Thanks a lot. Thank you very much.
Okay.